Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Commodity TV, and here today with the Precious Metal Summit Europe. And we have for the first time Precipitate Gold with us, and Jeffrey Wilson, who is really early up here at 3:30 in Vancouver, wants to give us an interview. Jeffrey, yeah, good morning in that case already to you. Hope you are fine.
Doing well and energized by the meetings and the presentations of the conference. So I'm happy to be here. Thank you very much.
Super, fantastic. Okay, then let's move it because it's really tough for you. I know that. Precipitate Gold, what is the company doing? You are in the Dominican Republic, and I think you have three projects altogether. So maybe you can give us a short overview on the company, please.
Yeah, Precipitate is a junior exploration company. We're very much focused on the discovery and sort of resource delineation side of the business. So early stage exploration, looking to find meaningful deposits that can attract mid-tier and major companies who are, going to be in need of, you know, supply going forward as this gold market appears to be continuing to be bullish and moving in the right direction. And so we've, as you said, we've got three projects, and I think we're sort of a well-balanced portfolio whereby we've got one project that's currently under an earn-in with Barrick, and I can speak to a little bit of how we got there. We've also got another project that is immediately adjacent to a company called GoldQuest Mining, and GoldQuest has a 2.5 million ounce deposit at their Romero project. We have a significant land package in that same geological belt, and have been sort of idle with that one for the last couple of years, but we're re-engaging our activity there. And most prominently at the present time, we have delineated a new target, or in the process of delineating a new target on a project called the Ponton project. That's about 25 kilometers away from Barrick's big major mining deposit, the Pueblo Viejo. And we believe we're on the cusp of a first phase of drilling for that project between now and the first quarter of next year.
Mm-hmm. Okay, super. Then let's go directly to the Barrick project, I would call it. Barrick holds also 12% in your company. Maybe you can explain how that came. And as you are next to the Pueblo Viejo mine, and your project is called Pueblo Grande Project, you have a 70% earn-in. Can you describe that? What's going on there? How did you came on that? And what are the next steps?
Yeah, so it's a bit of a long story, so I'm going to make it concise and short. Essentially, we picked up the ground surrounding Barrick's Pueblo Viejo about 18 months ago, maybe 24 months ago. Gold was under $1,100 an ounce. The Dominican Republic was a little out of favor. And we as an industry were competing with the likes of crypto, et cetera, et cetera. And so the company that held that ground adjacent to Barrick's mine decided that gold was no longer the place to be, and they wanted to become a cannabis company. So we bought that that project. We bought about 10,000 hectares that sits right up against the claim boundaries of Barrick's, one of the top five mining operations in the world, for $25,000 cash and shares of Precipitate. Inside of 12 months, we did our own geochemical work, geophysical work. We delineated targets. We were about to go drilling, and Barrick came along and said, we'd like to start talking. Now, the guys that had it before us had that ground for 10 years. We never had a deal with Barrick. We had it for 12 months, and Barrick wanted to do a deal. And so we structured a deal right before we went drilling, whereby Barrick has the right to earn 70% of our project, our Pueblo Grande project, which surrounds their mine site, by spending a minimum of $10 million US over 6 years. They must complete a minimum of 7,500 meters of drilling. But most importantly for me, I mean, anybody can go and spend $10 million US. It doesn't necessarily mean you're spending it well. Mm-hmm. Barrick must deliver a pre-feasibility study at the end of that six-year term. So not only do they have to spend money, but they have to deliver pre-feasibility in 6 years.
And they pay for it.
And they pay for it. So they've got to spend $10 million US in exploration, deliver a pre-feasibility study, and at that point, they can earn their 70% interest in our ground. If they don't complete the earn-in, we would retain 100% right. And if they do complete the earn-in and get to 70%, one of the things I really like about this deal is oftentimes a major does a deal like this and then they say, oh, they give you this mine plan where it's $1 billion construction cost. The junior company can't contribute and they get diluted out to a royalty. We have the right in this agreement to call upon Barrick to arrange our 30% of project finance. so that we don't get unnecessarily diluted out. So we are not a project generator. We are not a joint venture model. But as we were gearing up to drill this target ourselves, we realized, you know, this is going to be a big endeavor. There are a lot of targets. There's going to be some deep drilling. And we just thought that, you know, this is a big company program. And to allow Barrick to finance this, carry ourselves for 30, you know, to have it retain 30% was in the best interest of our shareholders. And we also felt that we had some other target areas that were perhaps lower hanging fruit, as they say, that we thought we could spend our money perhaps a little bit more effectively on some other targets while Barrick is doing the work. Now, Barrick, as a final note on that, Barrick has indicated to us recently that they are gearing up for an initial phase of drilling already. They're proposing 2,500 meters in drilling here initially, perhaps between now and the end of the calendar year. And so we expect an announcement on that in the months ahead, followed by, of course, the assay results, perhaps in the first quarter of 2021.
Okay, great. Would that mean that only Barrick drills now the project, or would you drill also in addition to the project, or would you say, okay, now let's concentrate Barrick on it because they pay any way for that, and we move on with the Pontron project and the Juan de Herrera project? Now,
correct? Yes. The idea here would be that all of the drilling or exploration work within our Pueblo Grande project, which surrounds Barrick, would be conducted by Barrick. They will do all of the drilling on that project. They will finance all of the exploration work on that project, and all of that, all of those expenditures will be applied against that $10 million U.S. Requirement. So yes, to the latter part of your question there, we, upon signing that deal in April of this year, where, as you mentioned, also we tied in a $1.4 million financing from Barrick. So they put $1.4 million into our company in an equity financing. That got them 12% of our stock. And no strings attached to that. We can spend that money as we see fit. It was also just a straight share, no warrants. It's not a unit, just shares. And so we now are able to take our working capital. We've got that $2 million or so in the treasury now, and focus on Ponton. And we've done about, you know, 5 or 6 months worth of work there since we signed the deal with Barrick at Ponton. And that's coming together now to be looking as if it could be drill ready here relatively soon.
Mm-hmm. Super. Okay, let's move aside of Pueblo Grande. Let's have a look on Ponton and Juan de Herrera. What is the plan for 2021 here with those two projects? And where do you see, let's say, longer term targets for those two projects?
Yep. Ponton is probably the nearest term catalyst in terms of significant exploration work. So we've been working on that project through the entire sort of COVID issue here. We've been fortunate enough to have local staff, local geologists. So we've been able to get into the field and do the necessary geochemical work, sampling, geophysics. We did a survey of ground magnetics. And basically, we inherited a gold anomaly that had never been drilled on this project by prior operators. And in fact, Barrick asked to have the Ponton project be part of the earn-in. But we kept it to ourselves because we wanted to have something we could work ourselves. So we've done probably about six months worth of work, geochemistry sampling, mapping, and are now at a point where we have identified some very attractive high-grade rock samples within a gold anomaly where we're getting rock samples running up to 53 grams per ton gold. And this is all in a nice concentration. All of these high-grade samples are sitting within the same concentration. A nice sort of cluster, if you will. And so those samples, along with the gold soil anomaly, is really pointing us in a direction of where we want to drill this project. The present time, we are awaiting drill permits. That's been stalled a little bit because of COVID. And also, there's been a change in government in the Dominican Republic in the last couple of months, in fact, in August. And so what that means is all the ministries are undergoing personnel changes. And so our permits have kind of been a little bit in limbo there. But I expect to have our drill permits for Ponton, I think, in the coming weeks, if not month or two. And so in terms of a timeline, there's the potential that we could be drilling 2,000 to 2,500 meters of drilling at Ponton between now and the end of the year. more likely, maybe we commence that in the first week or two of January. But we also own our own drilling equipment. We bought drills out of receivership earlier this year. We bought $800,000 worth of drilling equipment for $80,000. And also we're lucky enough to bring in the crew that had worked with this equipment. And so we have a drill crew and a drill at the ready in country. That'll bring our drill costs down, and that will bring our access to drills obviously up because we have ownership of this drilling equipment. So we're hopeful that we can be active on Ponton within the next 2 or 3 months with about a 2,500 meter drill campaign, shallow target, maybe 200, 250 meter holes each to test a target that's got some beautiful high grade material at surface, but has never been drilled before. So that's an exciting sort of near term work program that we hope to have underway here soon. You asked about Wanda Herrera. Wanda Herrera is sort of over on the other side of the country in the West, and it's immediately adjacent, as I said earlier, to GoldQuest Mining's Romero deposit. And Romero deposit's fairly well known. You know, the guys at GoldQuest made a significant discovery there back in 2012. Their share price went from 6 cents to $2. They raised a lot of money. And they've delineated a 2.5 million ounce gold equivalent deposit there. But that project has been stalled because of permitting issues. It's in an area of the country where there is no existing mining operations happening. And so there's a little bit of a political massaging that has to happen there in order to move that project forward. And in the last 2 or 3 years, GoldQuest has done nothing. They have not been spending money there. They've basically said to the government, if you don't give us this permit, we're going to lay everybody off. And so there's been no activity for the last couple of years. We've had a change, as I said earlier, a change in government, a change in president of the country, partly due to COVID and the financial impact that that's brought about to a country that is so reliant upon tourism. There's been a lot of rhetoric from the new president about how they need to utilize their natural resources to get out of this financial crisis. And he's talked about oil and gas. He's talked about clean energy, but he's also talked a lot about mining. And so my belief, or our belief, is that Romero, our neighbor, is going to get that necessary exploitation permit in the months ahead. And when they do, I think that will be a real signal to the market that it's game on again in that part of the Dominican Republic. And we sit right up against their claim boundary over a strike of about 40 kilometers. And we've got a lot of very mature targets there. We've been working on that project for 8 years. So it's not an early stage play. This is a project that's got extensive amount of geochemical work, sampling, geophysics, airborne geophysics, ground geophysics, and we have drill permits for most of those targets on that project. So, you know, this is something that, you know, if you look at it on a map, it really does have, you know, district scale potential. Agnico Eagle put $24 million into GoldQuest about 2 or 3 years ago. And I've said very often that I think that it's well known that the purpose of that money was ongoing exploration and drilling. And so we think that there's a validation of the fact that we're there for the exploration upside, and a mid-tier company feels the same way. So we think this is an area that we really haven't got any value for the last couple of years because of the political uncertainty. We think there's a real optionality play there now. And as our neighbors potentially get a permit, we think that, you know, that could be a real driver and catalyst for us to get back and get active there again.
Yeah, absolutely. Fully understandable. So that means with the new government and all those new, I would call it, officials now in charge, you think in the light of COVID that really the climate has changed dramatically to the positive side for mining?
I do. I mean, I don't think it's solely because of COVID. I mean, this new government does have sort of a different mandate. And I think that they are pro-business, pro-foreign investment, and they're trying to create a more competitive environment for injection of investment. But COVID obviously has been a significant compounding factor that I think is forcing these politicians to be very tuned into having to generate revenue somehow. And so I've been fortunate enough to meet with some of the new appointees in the ministry and in the mines ministry and the deputy minister. And what I'm encouraged by is these are people who are not just career politicians. They come out of the private sector, and they've been appointed because of their backgrounds. And so this gentleman in particular understands mining. More importantly, more than understanding mining, because for a lot of bureaucrats, understanding mining means how do we get money from the mine? These guys recognize that mines come about because of exploration. Somebody's got to find these deposits. And so how do we create a platform that companies like Precipitate want to come and spend money in their country to try to find the next mine? And so I think that you're going to have a really nice environment here where politically, where there will be welcoming to companies like ourselves and trying to assist us in finding mineral deposits that can eventually be mines and generate taxes and generate jobs and improve infrastructure. So I do think that a lot of what COVID has brought about has been a focus on the requirements to utilize additional industries, because tourism obviously, you know, is not coming back very quickly, and it's been a very tourism reliant economy in the DR for a long time.
Absolutely. Super. Well, Jeffrey, thank you very much. That was very interesting. And it looks like that you have something really nice here for the future put together. And especially also with Barrick as a neighbor, GoldQuest as the neighbor, it looks really good. And you have the money in the bank to really start now your exploration programs. All the best for that. And I'm hoping for you guys that you can bring out some very good results.
Excellent. Well, thank you for the opportunity. It's been a pleasure speaking to you.
Thank you. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Precipitate Gold and Jeffrey Wilson, the president and CEO. And you heard it, Barrick Gold owns 12%. The drills start to turn earlier than they thought. They have earn-in agreement with Barrick together, and Barrick can earn in 70%. But also they have two more exciting exploration projects, I would call it, where the drills also will turn here very soon. The permits for the one are there, the other one are coming through. And I think the most important thing is here, first of all, a political climate change to the positive side. That is really good. And on the other hand, before you mine it, you have to explore it, you have to find it. And that's exactly why we need companies like this. And I would suggest you check the company out. Thanks for watching us, and bye-bye from Switzerland.